Mr. Hopkins, what problem we got here today?
Well, it looks like we're going to have to rationalize maybe our fraction here and get rid of some coefficients and maybe do a little work with our variables. And,
yeah. So we got some negative exponents here.
Negative exponents. What should we do?
Yeah.
Let me ask you a different question. Have you ever been in wood shop? Done any type of handiwork around the house?
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. So you do know how to use a hammer?
Yeah.
Did somebody teach you? How many of you have used, maybe I'll ask the rest of you, how many of you used a hammer and had a problem where you started hammering and the nail started breaking, going like this, and then you had to take it out, and then you went and got another nail because it was bent in half. So there was some process in you learning how to nail something into a wall. So I think of this idea that I can go into wood shop and teach you how to hammer a nail into a board. And that's a skill that's going to be necessary for you. But that doesn't teach you how to build a house. And I can go into wood shop and go a little further and have you build that birdhouse that all the kids in wood shop build, right? And I'm teaching you small skills that are going to become something greater. And in mathematics, we're doing the same thing. When I teach you how to add, that's not going to get you to, it's a tool that we're going to need to get to doing that Google search. But when you're just doing the addition or you're simplifying this rational expression, it doesn't seem to have a use. Well, if I just give you two by fours and a nail and a hammer and say, here, learn how to hammer, I can do that, but that's not going to help you build a house. Do you understand that? So this idea of the toolbox to me is to get kids to understand that they need tools to be able to build that massive thing that might be Google search or cell phones or Facebook or all the different things that occur, and they don't know what they're building yet.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to need those tools, but there's no way to know what am I going to build with that tool. And it's the same idea with my toolbox in that I can build a birdhouse and I might be the one who ends up building your house. Or I might be the one who, that was the last thing I built. And so this idea that for some of us in our mathematics classrooms, you're going to learn these tools because it's necessary for all people to learn these tools, but you may not know why you're going to use them. You may not use them. But there are people who do, and we need to find those people also so that we can continue to move forward as a society, especially with technology.